And welcome to a brand new Let's Play. Let's Play Mass Effect 3. This is the RPG Chick, finally on the last game. Yes, I have played Mass Effect 1 and 2. I'll put links or annotations here and here if you want to go watch those. Otherwise, you could watch my Part 0, the Genesis 2 prequel, which I'll put here. Mind you, it's not a basis for this Let's Play. I'm going to be importing my save from Mass Effect 2 in a little bit. That's just a little informative thing with my little informative video anyway, with my little notes, bringing you up to speed in case you don't want to watch 238 videos of my combined Mass Effect 1 and 2 playthroughs. I am going into this pretty much completely blind. All I know is that the ending sucks. I don't know how. I know there's a lot of controversy over it, but no, I don't know what the ending is. I don't know if the universe is destroyed, galaxy destroyed, Earth destroyed, all our friends and family die, you know, something like that. It's like, I don't know if that's the only ending or like the best ending. Well, the universe is still alive, but the galaxy is destroyed. I don't know. So anyway, I know that there are more RPG elements as far as the leveling and skills and such, or techniques, whatever you'd call them. And it also, though, improves and adds or something with the third-person shooter elements. The cover is better utilized, something like that. A few things I want to get into, just bear with me. These are things you should know if you're curious about the Let's Play and what's going on. I'm not going to be reading comments until I finish the game, which should be a few weeks before I start, you know, a few weeks before you see the ending video is when I'll begin looking at and answering comments. I do encourage comments. Current comments are not disabled. Talk amongst yourselves. Talk to me. It's just I'm not going to answer for a few months. But I will be answering comments then. And this is to stop the possible spoilerization. I had problems with spoilers from friends and strangers alike in the first two games. And I am foreseeing that this will be the most problematic game as far as people putting spoilers, especially regarding the ending. And it's not even so much as major spoilers, but just little hints here and there, which I'll be able to piece together. Like, well, I got a hint from so-and-so and so-and-so, and, you know, from a dozen people, and then I'll put together what the ending is, or what the end of the mission is, or whatever the hell. And that's no good. So, and I will do that. I have a very analytic mind, so, at least I think so. So I'll do that without even meaning to. So I'll end up, you know, helping you spoil it for me. So I do apologize. I hope you guys understand. And I don't... Is this debris? You know, because at first I thought they were missiles. Or I thought they were Reapers falling to Earth. Apparently this is Earth. Kind of looks like Earth, although I can't make any distinguishable landmarks. But yeah, it looks like debris. I mean, that's falling. It doesn't look like it's, you know, hitting in any trajectory that makes sense. Whatever I'm trying to say. So yeah, I hope you guys understand that about the spoilers and the no reading of comments. I would encourage you not to leave spoilers anyway, because there are some people who have never played the game and they're just watching me play it. There are some who are playing alongside me. There's one or two people, at least in Mass Effect 2, who are playing alongside me. Was a couple from Mass Effect 1 as well who were playing alongside me, and you know, just getting to a certain point and then watching like how I did that same mission kind of thing. So if you post spoilers like of things ahead of time that haven't happened yet, then that that would spoil it for them. And you could say, well, don't read comments, but I'm not going to be policing comments. Obviously, I'm not going to be looking at them. So this is just, you know, for their sake, I'm immune. They might not be. So anyway, as you notice, interface scaling mod. I have an interface scaling mod and interface scaling add-on installed. For some reason, when you change the resolution from whatever, I think I was at 720. I think it's 1280 by 720 resolution. You know, the HUD was nice and big. You could actually, you know, the captions weren't tiny, but once I changed to 1920 by 1080, it got tiny. So it didn't scale up with the resolution for whatever reason. So these two mods, or the mod and add-on mod, fix that. I did try to, I tried to add ALOT, a lot of textures, from Mass Effect 3, and spent about 2 days doing so. About 10 hours out of my life gone. Well, I did do other things in the background, like watch videos and, you know, edit and stuff like that, answer other comments, whatever. But, yeah, the game wouldn't start. It wouldn't start at all after I added those mods, so I had to completely do the repair option from the Origin client and start over, overwrite all those mods, which just broke my heart. There's a lot of time out of my life there. It was insane. And I am going to try to put those back in like a week or so, you know, from here, from when you're watching it. So I'm just going to make sure I have a nice backlog of stuff. I'm not going to lose my save game. They're just textures. If it doesn't work again, then screw it. But as for now, anyway, we're going with the vanilla, you know, except for the interface is just enlarged. So I will try that in the future. Alright, so those are my mods. Yeah, you notice when you click this, it's a slowed down. I'm pretty sure it's the same sound, more or less. It's just the pitch is decreased from the first game. It's lower. I noticed that. I noticed things like that. Now in this playthrough, Tali is dead, died in the last mission. I chose her as a leader and she was not a good, you know. This always stutters. I don't know why. It's not because I haven't noticed anything else stuttering in the game other than this. Or just looks like that. So we got Galaxy at War, Galactic Readiness Reading 50%, Terminus Systems, everything's 50%, Attican Traverse, Earth Systems, Alliance Space, Inner Council, and Outer Council Space. I don't know what this is about, but I guess I'm going to find out. Allied forces are being pushed back by the Reaper slowly but steadily. Okay, so anyway, about Tali. Yeah, I decided not to. I mean, some people wanted me to reload. Some people were not happy. And I don't blame them. I'm not happy. But I want to stay true to the playthrough. I don't want to just, you know, fix everything bad that could have happened. And this does, couple people pointed out, this does make my playthrough unique, as a, you know, we'll see what the game is like without a Tali. It's not a universe I want to really live in, but we're going to live in it nonetheless for the next 100 plus videos. I hope you guys understand. I just feel it was a cheap tactic. I mean, I could have easily gone back and recorded the video over and nobody would have known. I could have gone and said, you know, guys, I'm reloading. And, you know, most people would understood that, I think. But, yeah, this is real, you know. I want to make this as real and as immersive as possible. So, yeah. People die. It's a way of life. And I hated doing it, and I hated sticking to that rule that I have. That, you know, I've pretty much had that rule since the beginning. If you look at my Skyrim playthrough, Lydia died 20-something episodes in, you know, and I tried to have a little, you know, funeral for her and everything. And I've had a lot of followers die in my Skyrim playthrough, and I didn't bring them back, even though sometimes I really wanted to. So that's just, you know, I felt I should explain that. I don't really know how else to explain it. I felt it would be cheap to just, you know, restore and like, okay, Tali is magically okay now, and it never happened. You know, although I did do so through Mass Effect 2 and maybe one with some minor things, but I felt this is, I don't know, this is a major thing. War is hell, and we're at war with the Reapers, collectors, maybe past tense with collectors, Geth, or some of them, maybe? Although supposedly we rewrote them. So that's one of the things I chose in the Mass Effect 2. We rewrote the Geth to not want to help the Reapers. So that's the Terminus systems. 2, 3. I'm just noticing this Council space is here. Earth Alliance here. Alright. So anyway, yeah, I did play a little ahead. So up to when we find the kid in the vent. And I have not played past that. So everything else after that is blind. Now, yeah, it's funny. There is a... there's a in-game manual. So I might be looking through this, you know, at a later time. Off-screen. I'm just going to read it. I'm not going to read it on screen and everything. But anyway, options, because I always like to see this myself, and maybe you guys like to as well. Keeping this at normal. Didn't have a problem doing so in Mass Effect 2. Mass Effect 1 I did. I changed Mass Effect 1 to casual, but this one will remain as normal, at least for as long as possible. Hopefully we'll stay there. Off, auto level up is off. Auto save all this crap is on for now. These things may or may not toggle off as they become, you know, pretty much extraneous and like, duh, yeah, I know I can, I know where to exit cover and stuff, so I might change those at a later time. Full decisions. Kind of crazy that you can have the game make all the decisions for you. I can't imagine playing like that, but it's just me. Subtitles on for you guys' sake, and I like to read them too. Shepherd's helmet off in conversations. Great. We did not have that. I'm surprised there was not even a mod in the game for Mass Effect 2 for that. So that'll be nice. I can use whatever helmet I freaking want to. Squad mate helmets default off on. Yeah, remove their helmet in conversations. So chose the language, yeah, English. I don't speak anything else, so. Key bindings, pretty much the same as in the first game. Now we have this navigational assistance, which I guess is the same as map, I'm not sure. But this, it displays a text thing, you'll see. On screen, there's a text prompt, what have you. I don't even know what this is. Mouse dampening. Turn this on for precision. Camera movement. Well, we have it on by default, so I guess we'll check it out. Everything else seems fine. Graphics. I got all this on, of course. Also, anisotropic filtering. There's a setup utility that you can run, and I set that to 16x as of now. Anisotropic filtering is at 16x. As far as the INI file, you can change things with the shadows. I'm not sure if you can change with anti-aliasing or not. I haven't messed with the INI file yet. I may do so in the future. I only noticed shadows, but I was really just skimming through it, so if there's other options, I'll change it, you know, and see how that works. Sound. This game is pretty quiet, so I have everything up to 100%, and I'm still louder than everything. So I hope it's a good range. I try not to yell and stuff, although I can't guarantee that. Husks can be scary when they get right in your face. Yes, I have a Sennheiser headset. So, yeah, done. I'll stop blabbing, and new game, import, Mass Effect 2 character. Brittany Shepherd, named after my daughter, my oldest daughter, created, May 18th. So yeah, I'm a spacer, war hero, class Vanguard. I'm going to keep the class the same. Although I do see some others that appeal to me. I kind of like the fact of keeping the same, you know, what do you call it? The same class. I forgot to say. DLC I have installed. And if I remember, I'll put this somewhere. From Ashes, which is two missions, a new squad member, and some weapons. Leviathan, which is many missions. Omega, which is five missions. Citadel, which I'm guessing takes place in a Citadel, which is many missions and extended cut. Five DLCs installed. If I remember, I'll list them here. So, just so you guys know, if anyone asks, hey, did you install this DLC? Look back 15 minutes into this LP or so. Sorry, I'm blabbing on and on. But this is important stuff. I will repeat, as far as the I'm not reading comments thing, for people jumping on, now and again, I'll repeat that, but otherwise, yeah, everything else is, yeah. That's it. Alright, so new game. Select career. Alright, so, alright. Can you import from... This information doesn't seem to change. Well, this does, but... Shadowbroker base. This was after I left Aratat. Right, this is my LP. So let me just see. 919 at 838. Alright, we'll take this one. So I saved the Rachnite Queen, rescued Ashley Williams on Vermeer. She was with the Salarian team. So by doing so, I also saved the Salarian team. The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few. And plus she was stuck in a situation, and so I had to help her, and Caden volunteered to stay with the bomb, so that was his wish, whether it was correct for him to do so or not. So that's why I chose that. And I couldn't commit genocide on an entire race, so I saved the Rachnite Queen, whether that's a good idea or not. Seems so far to be good. I chose to sacrifice the Council, being so that, I later found out it doesn't make a difference, but I was afraid without that, the extra starships and firepower, that it would be more difficult or impossible to defeat, what's his name? Or what's its name? Sovereign. Almost forgot it. I saved Malon's data, right? Which is, if you recall, is I have trouble remembering, Dr. Morden's protege, or assistant, as it will. So I saved his data, kept Rex alive. I chose to rewrite the Geth heretics rather than kill them. That's a very interesting decision, which, you know, they're both horrible decisions. But, you know, should we kill them instead? Destroy them all? At least they get to live on, right? Destroy the collector base. Yes. Screw you, elusive man. Destroy the collector base. Survive the suicide mission with 11 squad mates. I guess Tali would have been 12. I romanced Liara before Mass Effect 2, and I stayed faithful to Liara in Mass Effect 2. So important. Genetic scan in progress. Attempting to match personnel records. So I'm gonna go custom, of course. Records not found. Technology is not that useful. Presets. I'm not even gonna mess with presets. Wow. Just a little bit of tone. Now I think complexion. You've got three. Yeah, we've got three options. So this makes it. You can already tell the difference just against the collar here. Face size. Ooh. Reminds me of the guy from Next Generation with the worm thing parasiting him. Cheek width. It's not so much high cheekbones, right? It's the cheeks themselves. Oh, cheekbones are here. You can't. Wait. Well, her hair is in the way there. I don't even know where it was, but I guess this is okay. Some cheekbones, not crazy. Well, that's cheek width again. What am I doing? You can barely tell, though. I guess that's good enough. The cheek gaunt, I've learned, makes her look malnutritioned or something. Ear size, I'm not gonna mess with that. I'm not gonna mess with ears. Eyes. Eye shape, I found out I don't like the eye shapes other than like this one and maybe one other. Yeah, no. No. I guess it's okay. Oh my god, freaky. So what's the real difference between this? Got big eyes there. What big eyes you have? Or is this versus this? You know, I'm gonna keep it like that. Freaky. Eye depth. Brow depth. I'm gonna mess with the brow stuff. I found my color of that bright purple is like gone. I'm not even sure if they had it in the second game at all. I remember it from the first game. I guess we'll go with this. It's violet-ish. Jaw width only gets wider, not thinner. Okay. Chin width. Make sure we don't look freaky from the side. Now that collect the other mouths either. This kind of looks like Shepard from the other games, that mouth. So what's the real difference between this and this? Constructing profile. Depth. Yeah. We have it here. We can make it a little bit more. Mouth height. Yeah, I don't really want to screw with this. Six. I'm counting so I get it exactly where I want it to be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think it's fine the way they have it. Nose. Shape. No. Too small. Bent, even. You know. On the upturned nose. Like, you can always see her nostrils all the time. No real difference between these two, you notice that? Except the shadow changes or something. Probably from the side, you can tell. Yeah. That's like bent in. I don't know. I don't like the upturnedness of it. It's definitely not that. Definitely not though, pig nose. Too small. You know, about... I don't like it bent like that. Yeah, this is gonna be just bull crap. Sorry, guys. It's just... It's kind of weird looking from the side. I'm not really that excited about any of these noses. I guess that one's alright. It's just from the side, they all look crappy. What do you think? A little change with the height. Make it a little less, like, tiny-ish? I don't know. I don't know! Oh, God! Is this the same one I was on? I think this is the same one I was on. I think we're settling with this nose, guys, because I don't... You know, it's not bad, though. And it looks good from the side. Yeah, it's a little perky kind of nose. Whoop! Sorry guys, this is probably boring as hell to watch. I know some of you like watching this stuff though. Why? I don't know. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. I think that's pretty good so far. Now the hair, we'll have fun. Before I even do color, I'm gonna mess with different... Definitely not that. That's kind of look like classic Shepard, at least for my game. Torn between that and the classic Shepard look. Hold on. The mouth doesn't get any... I want to make the mouth smaller. This is under the... Yeah, a little smaller. Whoa. Oh wait, that's not what I want to do. No. I'm so picky this time. You know, I think she looks good like this. I think maybe that nose and that mouth go right together. Maybe a little fuller. I think we're good on that. So yeah, the hair like that, and then the hair color. That's a little too red. That's like almost pink. It's purple. That's cool though. I'm tempted to go purple. I like that color red. That's a little too much. Yeah, this color red, it's good. And I changed it. Just wipe them back into my brow. Brow color. And let's just check brow first. Fierce! You're a fierce warrior. What? I clicked out of it somehow. My god, no brows. Going with the minimalist version here. I don't want arched for her face. I don't feel it's right for her face. I don't like arched to begin with, so. Way too bushy. Dark. Okay, brow color. Turn off it. That pretty much matches the hair. Yeah, you definitely don't want a thick with that. That looks crazy. Yeah, we'll go there. And that's it, right? Brown color, yeah. Blush color, which is under the H, so I don't lose it, because this is pretty good. Let's go a tiny bit redder. Lip color. Yeah. Maybe. Yeah, we'll go with that. I don't know. I still feel like they need to improve with the facial thing, the facial profile thing. Eyeshadow color. And we started here, right? I guess it's nothing, and then we've got kind of smoky. No, we'll go smoky like that. Wow. I can't believe we're running so... Sorry guys, this is going to be the entire first episode. Vanguards are feared for their high-risk, high-reward combat style, closing quickly on enemies and destroying them at short range with weapons and biotic abilities. They are outfitted with L5N implants, enabling them to perform a biotic charge that strikes the opponent with incredible force while bringing the Vanguard in for close-range combat. Now, I know I don't use charge that... I didn't use charge that much in Mass Effect 2. But from what I understand, you're a little more protected when you charge, and like immediately afterward, I think. So we got incendiary ammo, cryo ammo, charge, Nova, which is new, I think, unless they've something else renamed, shockwave and pull, which is pretty much the same. Someone spoiled something for me saying that shockwave isn't effective, as effective, so I don't know. Hopefully we can still have a bonus power, I can choose something else, because I really enjoyed that shield draining power that I got from... I forget who I got it from. I don't want to sit here trying to remember. She looks pretty good. She looks pretty good, I have to say. I still move her head around. So it's got a nice profile, that's for sure. You can see the cheekbones and everything, and the blush on the bones and all that good stuff. And then you can look up and look down, and her eyes actually go up and down. Weird looking. Okay, so a spacer, war hero, and vanguard. Please review the above information and click accept to update your records. Yeah. This is going to be the entire first episode. Sorry about this, guys. I'm late uploading anyway. As I speak, it's 3:16. I usually upload by 2, so I still have to load and render the video. Loading takes time as well, and then rendering, which is also saving, and then I have to upload, and I have to add annotations and stuff. So I'm really sorry about that. Tomorrow should be normal time anyway. And I'm gonna sign off here, but I'm not saving. I'm just gonna continue into the next, you know, game. You'll see me here tomorrow. I'll pick up right at this screen. So thanks for watching. See you next time when the game actually begins. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.